Hi, lifelong learners. Would you trust a computer to drive? Today we are talking about the future of driverless cars. They are here to stay, and we're going to see more and more of them in the future. By 2030, 30% of cars in Dubai are scheduled to be driverless. The driverless vehicles of the future will park themselves, travel at high speed with almost no gaps between vehicles, and MIT has even proven we won't need traffic lights in the future. Cars will just sink at intersections and move forward without stopping. KPMG predicts that accidents will reduce by 80% by 2040 with the implementation of these cars. And if you think about cost, two-thirds of the cost of a taxi fare is for the driver. So a driverless taxi will be much cheaper. A likely outcome is that you'll be in a carpooling program with your friends and family. The cars will self-drive and just pick you up and drop you off. To understand the future, we need to talk about the six levels of driverless cars. At level zero, it's a car that your father or your grandfather learned to drive on. There's no automation, except perhaps gear changing. The driver controls everything. At level one, you have assistance in one direction, latitude or longitude, i.e. you have cruise control and perhaps emergency braking. The car can do one thing at one time. Many cars in 2017 are already at this level. Level 2, the driver is responsible for driving, but has assistance in both latitude and longitude. So the car can change lanes by itself. It keeps you in your lane, you indicate, it checks for vehicles, and then safely changes lanes for you and settles you in the new lane. It also keeps a safe distance from you and the car in front and behind. The driver is still actively involved in the vehicle, however. Level 3 is interesting. The driver needs to be actively monitoring the vehicle at all times and ready to take control. But the car should handle most situations. This is a little dangerous, because it's likely that the driver won't be fully engaged, and this will lead to accidents if they're required to take over. As a result, many manufacturers are trying to skip from level 2 to level 4. Because at level 4, the car is fully autonomous in some environments, such as driving on a highway. If it enters an environment outside its operational design domain, the ODD, it will safely transition to a human driver. Ford is aiming to release a level 4 car by the year 2021. Level 5 is the highest level. The car is equal or better than a human driver and can handle all situations, including driving on non-sealed roads. Potentially there's no steering wheel, no option for human control. Manufacturers are currently focused on level 4, which may mean the next generation of people may never learn to drive. What a world we live in. So, would you trust a computer to drive? Post below. If you enjoyed this, give us a thumbs up and subscribe by clicking the button and the bell below. Thanks for watching.